So this is the highly requested my favorite false lash video. While I was collecting all of the false lashes that I tend to wear over and over and over again, I realized the majority of them are now mink haired lashes. And I know it's gonna be because everyone's gonna, or not everyone, but certain people will freak out as soon as I say that, because they're like, oh my god, are you just so superficial that you need to wear minks on your eyes? It's really not about the fact that they're mink, guys. It really isn't. If you haven't tried mink eyelashes, then you can't really knock it. You can't. And especially because the brands that I wear Velour Lash and Mink Lash brand, and they are 100% cruelty free. They use the hairs that naturally shed off minks, because minks shed just like any other animal. They shed. They do not do anything else but shed and take the hairs and put them on the lashes, regardless if you believe that or not. But that is the brand's motto. If you do a little bit more research into the brands that I show, then you can definitely check out their websites down below and judge for yourself. But yes, I love those two lash brands so much. I have a few other lashes that aren't mink hair to show you guys, just to give you a little bit more variety and mention a few more that are more affordable. I don't have every single lash, especially the ones that I only wear once. I kind of go through those quickly. I'll mention those. I'm gonna go through the ones I wear the most. Let's start with the ones I'm wearing right now, and these are the Velour Lashes in Wispy Me Away. And these are one of their new wispy styles. Wispy lashes are very, very flattering, and they're very, very natural. It's just the way the hairs are positioned. Aside from mink hairs looking very natural, fluttering, glamorous already, wispy styled, it looks glamorous, yet not too much. Almost like really good lash extensions, which I've always been interested in, but really, I don't think I can keep up with those. So it can be reused up to 25 times, as they say. I've worn mine a lot of times. I've pushed at least certain pairs close to 20, and I've never thrown any away. I still just keep using them, and I just maintain them really well with, you know, removing the glue after it dries and just keeping the bands nice, storing them in their boxes. These are my favorite when it comes to wearing something. Let's say, like, today I'm wearing basically no eyeshadow, just liner and lashes and a bold lip. It's a very quick way to make yourself look put together and like you tried really hard, when it really didn't take longer than maybe 10 or 15 minutes just to throw on some liner, lashes, lips, and, you know, face makeup and eyebrows. But yeah, it's a quick way to get out the door and look fabulous if you are not blessed with natural lashes that you could just put mascara on. If I had really nice natural lashes, I would love to just put mascara on, but that's not the case. I'm going to list all the prices down below so I don't have to keep looking up the prices of each lash. So these are my current favorites, and these are the ones I wear a lot because they're just not too long and they're nice and tapered. I like lashes that are tapered from the inner corner and a little thicker on the outer corner because of the way my eyelids fall. I have a little inner lid problem, so if I have really thick haired lashes on, it tends to like fold over and make my eyes tear and all that jazz. The second pair are also by Velour, and they are the Wispy Sweet Nothings, another one of their new styles, and they are on back order right now. A lot of these are on back order because wispy styles are just amazing. These are the more dramatic versions of the Wispy Me Away lashes. They are longer, they are thicker, they are denser, but they are still wispy and a little bit pricier. Love those. Other style that I really like is the Lashaholic one. I wouldn't think I would like this because they are super, super dense and super, like, wham. But these are really nice, depending on the look you're going for. And I wouldn't pair this with a bold lip, personally. But these instantly make your eyes look, like, dramatic and smoky, even if you're not wearing that much eyeshadow. So I really like these just when I want a little more oomph to my eyes. And they are all very comfy. What I like about Velour's lashes, aside from their appearance, is the bands are flexible. They are not uncomfortable. If I had to rate them on a scale of 1 through 5, I would give them a 4 or 4.5. I don't know. I've never really had lashes on that feel like just about nothing, but these come pretty close. And then my favorite style I have in the old packaging. I've been a fan of their lashes for a very long time now, years now. They are the Strike a Pose lashes. They're not in the case right now. These are the packaging for it. And they are one of their first styles. Strike a Pose is like my go-to. They look good on just about anything. I have tutorials using those lashes. I wear those so much, aside from the new styles that just came out. Those look good on any look, in my opinion. Those are very safe. You can't go wrong with those. Just the right amount of denseness. They're not natural, but they're not too dramatic to the point that you feel like a drag queen or anything like that. Those are also back ordered right now. They are amazing, so worth it. And sometimes Velour Lash is actually on Hot Look with their old packaging. So if you're interested, definitely just, you know, check out Hot Look. I'll leave a link down below. Now, the other lash brand that I like is Mink Lashes, and this is their packaging. It has a little rose gold font. Very cute. Nice and simple. The inside is also rose gold. And these are just the same, genuine Mink lashes, handcrafted, cruelty-free. My favorite of their lashes would be their Winks and Kisses lashes, and I know it's like weird to just hold up a random lash. I had these in my Dolly Wink eyelash case because I wear them so much, I just don't even take the time to put them back in these boxes sometimes. I wear them a lot in my videos, especially my recent videos. They are really nice. They're super tapered. They give a very nice drama to the eyes because they have longer points, and it just looks amazing. I think it would look flattering on everyone, especially monolids. Though I'm not a monolid, I really think those would look really good on monolids. If you've seen my how to apply false lashes video, I show those at the end. Another style that I show in my how to false lashes video is their BFF lashes, and these are a lot like the Velour Lash Strike Oppose, but they are not as dense, so more natural. If you're into the more natural look but you want length, then these are great. They will be your BFF for sure, properly named, no doubt about it. So those are my two favorite from Mink Lash. I especially lean towards Winks and Kisses, so if you're interested in any, I would say go for those. I have a coupon code for Mink Lashes, which is NOW10. You can get 10% off anything at any time. I'll link them off in the info box and type that down below. Now to go for something a little bit more affordable, I really love Model 21 lashes for the price. My sister-in-law grabbed me some when she went back to Vietnam a couple months ago. She grabbed me a lot. You can get like a sheet, like 10 for like a dollar. And you can find these, I want to say, on eBay, or you can find them on their website, of course. The thing is, the numbers that I have on mine don't really look like the ones on their websites. I really don't know what to say about that. I like the number 25 and number 4 lashes. If I want to use something just really affordable and really disposable, then I go to these. These do not have as comfortable lash bands as the Mink Lashes or the Velour Lash brands. These can come kind of funky. They're not as consistent. The bands will be different from pair to pair because of the price. You kind of got to accept that. And sometimes when you yank them off the little glue strips, they get all jacked up and bent. But they are affordable, and they do give a lot of length without a lot of effort. They look natural, but they glamour up any eye. I use these a lot when I do my friends' makeup because they don't want me to use expensive lashes on. They just want something, you know, quick, pretty, easy that they don't feel bad throwing away. And I'm like, yeah, definitely. So I use these all the time. I have sheets and sheets of these. The band is a little bit more noticeable because it's thicker and it's a little bit more uncomfortable. So keep that in mind. And the last lashes I want to talk about would be Elf's lashes. I have none currently. I need to go buy more at Target. They are a dollar a pair. Very great. I love their dramatic lashes, but to me they're not dramatic. They have two styles. They have natural and dramatic. The natural ones don't look that good on me. They're a little too short and they look kind of stubby on me. But I like the dramatic lashes because they're kind of wispy. And they are lightweight, the band is flexible, and because they're a dollar and so easily accessible compared to like the Model 21 ones I have to get online, you just go to Target and grab some or order a bunch when the Elf has them on sale. And it's just really easy to use. I don't find those as flattering on camera as I would my Mink style lashes though, because they're really close to the liner and they make my eyes look a little bit more raccoon-y. But they are very flattering in person. So if you want something quick in at the store, you can definitely try those out. I do like Revlon's lashes as well, but I don't really have any favorites from them. I do like certain lashes from eBay. I'll link off the seller that I like down below. I've used all my eBay lashes, so I have nothing to show you guys. But I can type out some information about some that are really affordable that I do like the lash band on. I do find very flattering down below if you guys want to check those out. Thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in a later video.